In this tutorial, we will learn about the lookup table. In short, we can write as LUT. So in this tutorial, we will learn about the internal structure of LUT, how the logic is implemented by using LUT. So we know that the basic unit of FPGA is nothing but LUT. So lookup table is the basic unit for the FPGA to perform, to store or to perform any logic, either arithmetic or logic, or either logical or memory. So first of all, we will see some basic example how the lookup table is. By the name itself, it is a table. So it holds, basically it holds truth table of a logic. Suppose we can give you an example, any function which has a truth table. Suppose I have an AND gate. So I am taking two input AND gate, which is A and B, and output Y. So this is the truth table for my two input AND gate. So it is transferred to the same logic we will implement using LUT. So by using LUT, so here there are two inputs and one output. So the basic element to represent LUT is nothing but MUX. MUX is the basic element to represent LUT. So here our output is Y. So this is our output. So output is either 0 or 1. So 0 or 1. If it is 0, we have to check one condition. If it is 1, we have to check one condition. So coming to the 0, if it is 0, when it will be 0, this three things, it will be 0. So it depends upon A and B. So first of all, we will give with B. So if it is B, so Y is 0 or 1. So if it is B, so it is better to give a A. Suppose it is A, so it will default 0 and 1. So if it is 0, if it is 1. If it is 0, my Y should be 0, no problem. If it is 1, it is depends upon my B. Wait for a minute. So if it is 0, my output is 0. If it is 1, my output is same like B. So it is nothing but B. So I can represent the B also one MUX. Instead of writing B, we can represent as B. So B, if it is 0 and it is 1. So this is like a nested MUX. Nested MUX. So in LUT is a LUT is a nested max representation. So in FPGA 7 series we have 6 input LUT, which is nothing but here there are 2 inputs. This is called 2 input LUT. If it is 6 input, you can imagine that that structure will be so. I am drawing for the 4 input LUT, so you can imagine 6 input LUT. So this thing I am giving as A. A is the select line. And here I am giving either 0 or 1, because these are the datas. I don't know what the data should be. 0 or 1, 0 or 1, 0 or 1. So these two we get B. B is the select line representing the 3 input. So this is the internal structure of the LUT for 3 input LUT. So nested MUXES representation is the internal structure of the LUT. So here the before you are executing, that means you are programming the array, programming the FPGA. While programming the FPGA, the tables, the table nothing but this one, this one, this one, this one is concurred whether it is 0 or 1. So here this point, these are the tables. It will calculate whether it is 0 or 1, it is 0 or 1, it is 0 or 1. So while you dumping the code into the FPGA, the LUT calculates its table whether it is 0 or 1 or 0 or 1. So the tables were filled with 0 and 1. By giving a proper input, you will get your output to the Y. So this is a representation of 3 input LUT. In FPGA, it is a 6 input LUT. So you can imagine in a similar way that it is a representation of nested MUXES. So this is the structure of internal diagram of LUT lookup table, how it performs. The table is nothing but here the input of the MUXES are the tables. While you are programming, the LUT will calculate the values in the table. By giving a proper input values ABC, the table value will flow towards the output. So this is the operation in which normal lookup table will do. So here 6 input LUT have 6 inputs, so the structure will be nested MUXES, and you will get a 1 output. So today we discussed what is LUT. Simple example to perform LUT. The main thing in this lecture is nothing but internal structure. Internal structure of LUT. So if you have thorough with these things, this tutorial will help you. Thank you. We will see in the next video.